AA's Legacy of Service by Bill W. Our 12th step carrying the message is the basic service that the AA Fellowship gives. This is our principal aim and the main reason for our existence. Therefore, AA is more than a set of principles, it is a society of alcoholics in action. We must carry the message, else we ourselves can wither and those who haven't been given the truth may die. Hence, an AA service is anything whatever that helps us to reach a fellow sufferer. Ranging all the way from the 12th step itself to a 10-cent phone call, and a cup of coffee, and to AA's General Service Office for national and international action. The sum total of all these services is our third legacy of service. Services include meeting places, hospital cooperation, and intergroup offices. They mean pamphlets, books, and good publicity of almost every description. They call for committees, delegates, trustees, and conferences. And, not to be forgotten, they need voluntary money contributions from within the fellowship.
AA's 12 steps are principles for personal recovery. The 12 traditions ensure the unity of the fellowship. The 12 concepts for world service provide a group of related principles to help ensure that various elements of AA's service structure remain responsive and responsible to those they serve. The short form of the concepts, which follows, was prepared by the 1974 General Service Conference. The 12 Concepts for World Service. 1. Final responsibility and ultimate authority for AA World Services should always reside in the collective conscience of our whole fellowship. 2. The General Service Conference of AA has become, for nearly every practical purpose, the active voice and the effective conscience of our whole society in its world affairs. 3. To ensure effective leadership, we should endow each element of AA, the conference, the General Service Board, and its service corporations, staffs, committees, and executives, with a traditional right of decision. 4. At all responsible levels, we ought to maintain a traditional right of participation, allowing a voting representation in reasonable proportion to the responsibility that each must discharge. 5. Throughout our structure, a traditional right of appeal ought to prevail, so that minority opinion will be heard and personal grievances receive careful consideration. 6. The conference recognizes that the chief initiative and active responsibility in most world service matters should be exercised by the trustee members of the conference acting as the General Service Board. 7. The charter and bylaws of the General Service Board are legal instruments empowering the trustees to manage and conduct world service affairs. The conference charter is not a legal document, it relies upon tradition and the AA purse for final effectiveness. 8. The trustees are the principal planners and administrators of overall policy and finance. They have custodial oversight of the separately incorporated and constantly active services, exercising this through their ability to elect all the directors of these entities. 9. Good service leadership at all levels is indispensable for our future functioning and safety. Primary world service leadership, once exercised by the founders, must necessarily be assumed by the trustees. 10. Every service responsibility should be matched by an equal service authority, with the scope of such authority well defined. 11. The trustees should always have the best possible committees, corporate service directors, executives, staffs, and consultants. Composition, qualifications, induction procedures, and rights and duties will always be matters of serious concern. 12. The conference shall observe the spirit of AA tradition, taking care that it never becomes the seat of perilous wealth or power, that sufficient operating funds and reserve be its prudent financial principle, that it place none of its members in a position of unqualified authority over others, that it reach all important decisions by discussion, vote, and whenever possible, by substantial unanimity, that its actions never be personally punitive, nor an incitement to public controversy, that it never perform acts of government, and that, like the society it serves, it will always remain democratic in thought and action.